Today, I will show you an entire step-by-step process of how to create a new AWS account. This is new, fresh operating system with absolutely nothing configured, and we'll be creating here new AWS account. So let me open the browser, and we'll navigate to something like AWS Free Tier. And what actually Free Tier is, we'll talk about it later. But now let me just explain shortly. It's simply an AWS offering that lets you using loads and loads of resources for a year for free. When you create new account, you can use those services for free for 1 year. But we'll talk about it later when we actually create resources. Now we're creating the account itself. As you can see here, I have create an AWS account. Let's click that because that's what we are interested in. Yeah. So I'm clicking this. It takes me to that web page with that create a free account button. Let's click on that. And maybe let's accept those cookies. And now what I need is some kind of email address. It can be any email address you use or you own. You just have to be sure you can access actually that email during the sign up process. Yes, I will just use gmail.com. So this is important bit. The one below, it's just an alias for your account. It can be anything you want it to be called. Automation Avenue, but it's not that important really. The email is important here. I click verify email address. And now I will have to just wait for the email to arrive. As you could probably hear, the email has just arrived and I've received a verification code. I have to type it here and click verify. Okay. Now we have to create the password for root user. We'll talk about it a little bit later, who is a root user, but now let's just create a password. And as you can see, it has to include uppercase, lowercase, number, and non-alphanumeric character. Just make sure you've got that all. Even when I just start typing, let's say capital letter, as you can see, first box is ticked, lower letter, now digit, and now non-alphanumeric. As you can see, all those boxes are ticked, so my password is good enough for them. Now I have to repeat it. And that's it. We can continue. Just wanted to note, you know, here on the left, you have a link if you want to explore those free tier products. So this is the link you can use. But never mind, at this stage, we'll just concentrate on the signup process. So I'll just click continue. I will save the password. And now it asks me for contact information. So it asks me if it's business account or personal account. I will treat it as personal account. Anyway, if it's business, it will ask you for organization name as well. Let's click personal. And my name is... You have to give them name and address, yes, and the phone number. And you agree that you've read the customer agreement. So we can go further to step 2. Now it asks you for billing information. That's where you have to provide your credit or debit card number, because as I said, there are some free services you can use, but you can actually, by signing up, you can use all services, the ones that are free and the ones that you have to pay for. That's why you have to put the credit card details. But in later videos, I will show you how to create a budget. This budget will inform you if you actually started using some services that you have to pay for. But for the time being, we have to put that information in to be able to progress. So that's the credit card, and we can go further. As I used my Revolut card, I have to confirm that in the banking application. I click confirm, and that authorizes this step. Now it asks me for a telephone number to use to confirm the identity. I will use the same that I used previously on previous page. Now the capture. Cool, I have it right. If it's completely messy, you can also always refresh it. You know, it will generate new one. Because some of them are generated in such a weird way that you can barely see what's there. Okay, now let's wait for the verification code sent to my phone number. And as you could hear, it's just arrived. And we can continue to step number 4. Here it asks me again what type of account I really need. So we'll go obviously with the free one. I don't want to pay $29 a month or $100. The free one is more than we need really. And that's it. We click complete sign up. As you can see, it was quick and easy process. And it says we are... Okay, as you could hear, AWS says we're activating your account, but I believe it's just been activated. So yes, received the email, it said that I can start using my account. So I can click either this button or that button, doesn't really matter. Let's maybe click this one. Go to AWS Management Console. And now it asks me if I want to sign in as a root user or the IAM user. We really only have root at this stage, but I will show you later on in next videos how to create IAM user as well. So for the time being, as there is no choice, we only have root user, we'll put the email address we used for the signup process. So for me it was gmail.com. We'll click next. And the password, the one that you just created as well for this user. And sign in. Not bad, is it? We are already in our AWS console. That's what it's called, AWS console, where we can do everything regarding this account or our resources. First thing I want to show you is here. That says Automation Avenue. Remember, that's the alias we actually pasted during the signup process. So instead of some long weird digits, it will be Automation Avenue will be used here. For you, it can be anything you want to name this account as. The next thing is we can see Stockholm. Well, already chosen, I don't know why, but that's what we call AWS region. This is where you want to create your resources. So as you can see, you can create it all over the world. Let me just change it to London, because that's the closest for me. But we'll talk about it later on as well, so don't worry about it now. What I want you to do is to activate multi-factor authentication for the root user. That's very important. This account has to be very secure. So what you can do, here in this search field, you can put IAM. IAM. We'll click that. And you can see, that even the Amazon itself, there is a security recommendation 1, add MFA for root user. To be honest, every single user you create should have MFA enabled, in my opinion, but root one is definitely one you need to create MFA authentication for. So we can add MFA here, clicking this button. And now we have a choice what we want to use as a second separate authentication method. So the easiest way, I think, is Authenticator app, which is chosen by default anyways. So you can call, for example, for me, it will be my Samsung phone. I can use that as an authentic, that doesn't really matter. It's just for you, information for you, where this authentication will arrive. And we can choose authentication app, click next. And now you can see you will have to install one of the applications on your phone, either Google Authenticator, Duo Mobile, or some other apps that the list of all applications you can see here. But basically, you need just one of them. Google is a really good one. I can recommend that one. And then, once you've installed that application, you have to click that Show QR code and just scan it with your phone. Once you scan it, you will receive MFA code, which you will have to paste here twice. I mean, first code and second code. This way, we will add that device as authorized one to receive the MFA codes. I will not do that because this is just temporary account. I will remove it later on, but you definitely should do that. Okay, so I think at this stage, I don't want this video to be too long. So I think that's it for today. In next video, I will show you how to create that budget before you start actually creating any resources in AWS Cloud. But you've got your own AWS account now, so congratulations. See you next time.